Kia ora. So it's Waitangi Day today. I thought the best way to celebrate Waitangi Day, or not celebrate it, is to go down, give thanks to Tangaroa and Hine Moana for the things that I worked through with them. And yeah, let's go do some releasing, some cleansing in the Moana and see what we can find. And I'm excited. I'm so excited to get the camera out finally. I've been thinking about it for a while, but I haven't had the battery to take it out. So yeah, so let's get out there and have a jam. I'm keen.
Thank you.
I just wanted to showcase a little bit about Aotearoa that, I guess, me from a year ago, 2 years ago, wouldn't have even known that this existed if I didn't start to push outside my comfort zones. The only reason why I'm here today in Wellington is because of that reason. I pushed myself out of that comfort zone, moving away from home and the comfortabilities of depending on my nan and depending on other people. Anyways, I know, I just wanted to showcase a bit of Aotearoa there. Opportunities that I get to stay out here, and this is something that is free for everyone to do. Anybody can come out here and do this and get these type of opportunities. I'm just sitting here with lots of gratitude. So I pulled up to a place where I can pull out the kina and take out the hua and the teeth. And so I'm just going to bring you fellas along, have a look. Probably run through a little bit on how to open the kina, pull out, and take the hua out, the power. Because obviously when I first started diving, that's information that I didn't know how to do. When I first got my first power, I was like, okay, so what now? So I think it's important that when we're showing how to catch our kaimoana or even our wild kai and stuff like that, it's quite important to show how to process it as well, because a lot of the times when I first started and I pulled out a power, I had to ask my nan how to, you know, pull hard. So some cool information that I learned, which is probably common knowledge, but I didn't even realise because I just thought shells were everywhere, is that if you can see shells along the beach, this goes for kaimoana as well, so pawa, kina, craze, if you can see it along the shoreline, when you walk along the shoreline, you can guarantee 95% of the time there's normally that kai in the moana. So right now I'm looking at all these cockle shells down here, so I can pretty much tell you that there are going to be some cockle either in here, over there, or they're coming from that way inwards. But yeah. And it's so crazy because I never liked kina when I first started diving or even before that, and now I get the cravings for it. So yeah, that's how you do it. That's how I do it anyway. So there we are, that's what we got. So for me, I like to, lots of different people do this a different way. I'll show you how my nanny taught me. Just your finger. And there's a trick as well. Normally you can put these in the, so you put these in the freezer for about a day, and then the shell, with the shell, and when you take them out, they're like really, really soft. So much easier to take out. But yeah. my camera cut out when I was over there trying to show you fellas how to take out the hua and the teeth. But anyways, this is what I got, 3 power and probably like half a dozen kina. Yeah, I'm probably gonna have a munch on this because I'm keen.